a little bit aggressive for me.
Nasty. I'm not saying SOB, right? Nasty.
So, and then you had mentioned that we can fix it. Like if it's an if it gets too negative. So my question for you is, does it matter what kind of emotion it is? Positive, negative, get them emotional? Is that what you're, was that the point you were trying to make?
Yeah, kind of. You're on the right track. Here's the thing. If we do, this is the insanity of our business. If we do the same thing that our everybody else is doing, that book I mentioned earlier, okay, the parasitic mind, it's about the logic of doing something. If we're doing the same thing over and over again, spending a lot of money and just doing what other people are telling us to do, and we're not making money, even though we're working hard. Should we keep, why do we keep, should we keep doing the same thing over and over again if it's not working? Isn't that, what do we, what did I, what's the word I just defined?
Vanity.
Insanity.
Insanity. Okay, so there's, we go back to the, let's go back to the foundation. What's the $1 million rule, everybody? Somebody tell me. People make
People make
Emotional decisions.
emotional decisions immediately and justify them later.
Yes. And so my job is to, when I speak to somebody, I want to do the things that will get this person to pay attention. We're in the attention business. That's what marketing really is. Can I get somebody to pay attention? If I have the same, if I can get them emotionally charged, and your point, positive or negative. Well, who is this guy? He's so full of himself. Who does he think he is talking to me? Tells me, he just told me I can't think about it. Okay. Do I have their attention?
Yeah, but
Oh, yeah. And it's negative.
I'm wondering if that quick emotional decision is, I'm done talking to you, click.
You know what? Ring, ring.
Hello.
Tanya, what did I, this is Claude again. Were we disconnected or did I just get you so mad you hung up on me?
I totally hung up on you,
Can
however.
I apologize?
Okay.
I'm somebody. Sometimes I just drink too much coffee and everything. I'm a new, I'm a transplanted New Yorker. Somehow they let me into California. Okay. And as you know, I just, you came to me with your problems, and I just want to, you know, when people tell me they want to think about it, I think they're just being polite. And you were being in, you know, when you said you want to think about it, why don't we just say it's over? It's no. I'll still send you some information and to help you out with that, with those problems you had. But you know, it's, let's just say it's over. Is that okay?
All
And
right.
I
So this is an
I'm
example.
sorry if I ruined your Monday. Now that it's over, and then you go right back into it again. I have really called up people and saved the sale. Even though they hung up on me. Do I get a lot of that? No. And am I really brutal and nasty? Let's ask Justin. Justin, am I brutal and nasty all day long?
Not really.
No. I'm a cream puff.
Can you finish that last part though? So you said now that it's a no.
No, okay. Yeah. Now that it's
Follow
over, Tanya, let me ask you something. You told me that you're sick of living in your mother-in-law's garage. Okay, it's not, you know, you want to get into a house. I have a house available. I'm getting, here's my problem. I am getting so many, Alex Pardo has called me 4 times and left me 3 voicemails. Okay, I've got Randy's call coming over this afternoon at 2 o'clock. I would love to put you and your family into this house.
I know, but you were pushing me for an
I
answer.
am,
I'm
I
not
am.
ready to make, I need some time. I'm not
Yeah,
ready to make a
you don't have
decision.
time. You want me to tell you the truth or just sugarcoat this?
No, I want you to tell me the truth.
You don't have time. This is, we're in a shortage right now. We don't have many properties. This is a property with owner financing. This is a property I can get you and your family into. It's not your final home. It's a starter home. And if I don't get you to look at the property today and make a decision, you're going to call me back maybe in a week or two, and I'm going to tell you the news, and you're going to be mad at me again.
Well, I appreciate that.
I just want to be straight up with you. But you know what? I love your feistiness, and you asked great questions. Stroke and nurture, stroke and nurture. If I can get you know, Randy's not coming till 12 o'clock today, Pacific time. If I can get you over there by 10:30, I'll be there at 10:30. I can show you the place. You can still say no to me. Don't worry. You just can't think about it because it's gonna be, I honestly, it's gonna be gone really fast.
Okay, that was a beautiful
save.
Reversal.
And this is a style, but you don't have to copy, God forbid, my personality. Don't do that. But, you know, use it your own way. But what's the psychology behind what I'm doing? Let's use the science. There's a lot of art. Okay, I'm a ham bone. But what's the science behind what I do?
It just gets them engaged, I guess.
Keeps them engaged. Even if they're annoyed with me? They hang up. Or how dare you tell me I'm not allowed to think about? Who do you think you are? Do I still have their attention? Do I still have a chance? How many of us have heard somebody say, you know, this is great, thank you, la-di-da, send me the contract, send me the information, I'll get back to you in the near distant future. And then they go in the witness protection program and we never hear from them again. Okay. Yeah. I think here's my attitude. Life is short. We got one shot to make it. And I know I have made decisions very quickly, even for expensive pieces of real estate. Okay. They can still get out of it if they want to. Okay. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of right of rescission and everything. I would just rather, am I burning bridges? I think is what you're really asking me. Am I burning bridges? Did we ever have that bridge to begin with? This is a little aggressive. There's no doubt about it. But does the question to ask yourself is, do we have rights in the sales process, or do we have to be that little chihuahua under the table on steak night?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you got a picture in your mind. You know, do you think being subservient to the prospect works? I mean, I'm not saying let's be nice, be polite. We want people to like and trust us, of course. But is there a point where we need to be assertive?
Yeah, definitely. And that's why I wanted to specifically ask you about, you know, bringing them back. We can fix it.
Yeah, we can fix it. How do you fix something? Real easy. What did I do before?
You apologized immediately.
I apologized. How hard was that? How much did that cost me?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah.
In the end, if you make the sale, no matter what, you win. Now, I'm let me qualify. Do business honestly, ethically, under promise and over deliver, and all the common sense things that we all know. But in the conversation, can we use different aspects of psychology? Scarcity. Okay. This property is going to be gone. Tanya, I'm telling you the truth. I got too many people calling me on it. I got years of experience on it. Can we use social proof? Social proof is what everybody else is doing. Should I do what everybody else is doing out there, even if it doesn't make sense? We're not going to get political again here, okay? Should I make sure that I qualify people for money? If somebody asks me a question, like Corey, that question Corey asked me in the role play, when can you deliver it? Okay, here's another thing from the gut sales method. You can write this down. Stalls and objections are opportunities to close. Did we see that before? He said, well, when can you deliver it? And then the first time Corey did it, what did he say?
I gave you everything right off the bat.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about it. Oh, we got a shitload of delivery trucks. We'll get it right. You know, we can do it right away. Okay. What happens when we use a little bit of little human nature, human behaviorism, and we say, you know, it could be a big problem. Oh, I don't know. My three favorite words in sales.
I don't know.
I don't know. Why are they my three favorite words?
Gives you time to think.
Yeah, that's a good point. Sometimes it gives you a good question, Tanya. I don't know. Nobody's ever asked me that. Well, you must have asked that for a reason, Tanya. Can you help me out a little here? What did you mean by that?
It allows you to get more information, too.
Right. Do you think sometimes prospects say things, but are just, they're just asking them because they think they're supposed to ask them and they're not really any meaning behind it? Or is there an agenda, another alternative agenda? They're trying to pick your brain, get free consultation. What happens when we turn a question into a question We've talked about this a couple of weeks ago. I think we did it. Turning questions into questions, feigning ignorance and things like that. Can you help me out? I'm not sure what you mean. That's a great question. You've done your homework. Why did you bring that up? And then you can go right to the close sometimes, by the way. So you mean if you could get the delivery, if you could get the price, if you could get the financial terms, if you could get the color of the tiles you want, if you could get a 4-bedroom instead of a 3, what would you, you wouldn't take action right away, would you? You wouldn't do so. You wouldn't want to move forward today, would you? Oh, well, no, I got to check my bank account.